Craig Carson.
Yeah, that's me. Detective Dan?
Yeah, you're early.
Didn't want to be late on my first day.
Well, this unit's not that important. Late or early doesn't really matter.
That what makes this precinct special? There's no slap on the wrist for sleeping in?
Yeah, no. It's much more interesting than that. Did you find this place okay?
Yeah, but if you're trying to show the city off to me, I would have gone with an establishment a little nicer than this.
Well, in this unit, you get used to places like this, and look at the bright side. The place has got character, at least. Hey, bartender, can I get a beer, please? Thank you. Now, so when you got a sign from the academy, what exactly did they tell you about the GPD program?
Well, at first I was a little confused. The whole working with Methuselans in the squad? Are they part of the psych ward or something?
No, genies.
Huh?
The Methuselans, we call them genies.
What's the difference?
Well, what did the textbooks tell you about them?
Methuselah syndrome was first discovered in 1938 by Dr. Richard Clavier after the failed testing of a new weaponized steroid system caused the test subjects to form a new purgatory cell, meaning...
Meaning that the suspended animation of simultaneous growth and decay. Continue.
And it causes semi-immortality. There hasn't been a recorded natural death in a Methuselan in over 70 years. And the outward sign of the genetic disease is graying of the skin.
Right. Well, you did learn your studies well, but there's a lot of things they didn't teach you.
What's this woman doing?
Her stage name is Betamax. She can take the potential energy of projected images on a screen and turn them into a reality. It's what she learned while she was in another dimension.
What do you mean she was in another dimension?
This file can tell you in more detail, but the gist of it is that the genies are so intellectually superior that they can move metaphysically from one dimension to another.
You mean like alternate realities?
Exactly. You see, the scientists over time realized that the Methuselan's disease eliminated their need for food and for sleep.
Sounds nice.
One would think. What the purgatory cells are doing is they're slowing down the metabolism to an extremely slow metabolic rate. It would seem this ever-wakening state of the genies would allow their neural activity to grow and grow. You know how most people use only 10% of their brain power? Well, the genies, they're using like 30 or more percent.
But I still don't get this whole phase and cycle thing.
Well, maybe it's easier if I explain it this way. Bartender, could I get 3 shot glasses, please? Now, let's say for an example, this is the genie. This bottom part is its body. The upper part is its mind. These are alternate universes. They're all in the genie's mind up here. And they go in and out of these metaphysically. Now back at the station, we use these bottling devices. These immediately recall the mind back to the body. It also helps to stabilize them. Hey bartender, how about a shot of universe for my new friend and me? Well, Craig, here's wishing you luck. I'll see you on Monday, Detective. Genie will be here soon, and I'm getting out of here.
I'm not meeting him Monday?
No, he's going to be here in just a little while. So good luck to you.
Thank you. Detective Carson.
Would you like a bookmark?
I'm Craig.
I know. I'm Mannix.
So you're the genie I'll be working with?
Yes, and I was hoping that before the weekend ends, we could get to know each other.
Thought orientation was on Monday.
It is, but when we're on patrol Monday, I don't want there to be any misunderstandings about what we're supposed to do for each other. Thank you, Detective.
Craig. Call me Craig.
Craig, you know what the most amazing part of the circus is? It's that their biggest selling concession is nothing. You see, when you walk up to the stand and you see that man running that white cone around in a circle, you think that he's collecting together candy. But what he's really doing is gathering air. That's what I'm supposed to do for you. Make something out of nothing. Now, my stage name is Manic Mannix, but I was born Richard Richardson, May 8th, 1945. On VE Day. In this small town named Brandsworth,
My uncle was born in Brandsworth.
I know.
How do you know?
I looked through your records. Also, now that I think about it, I went to grade school with your uncle. After that, I went to Brandsworth West. I played football. I took them to 2 state championships. But I'll always remember that second one. It was in November. It was raining on that field. I was wide open. I had my arms open and I saw the ball was thrown. I closed my eyes ready to catch it and you know what happened?
You got the pass.
No. I opened my eyes and I was in a house. I could feel hardwood floors under my feet. I looked out the window and there was sunshine.
I went into the other room and the dinette chairs were floating in the air and the countertops were made of something that looked like emerald.
When I woke up, they told me I had caught the pass, but I wasn't aware of it. I've been back to that football field over the years
and it's been many different things.
A restaurant, a church, military installation, a dance hall, and 15 different people's houses.
Yeah, sounds like a real trip.
Where?
What?
Where are we going?
I didn't say we were going anywhere.
Never mind. I'm out of my mind. Well, after that, I went to school for criminal justice and sociology, and eventually I just became a lecturer, going from college campus to college campus. But after a while, it all became just a sad magic act.
What was your last partner like?
A real by-the-book kind of guy. For 10 years, I had to put up with his rules. But you want to know something? Because of him, I still love bluegrass and I still hate cowboy killers.
You don't smoke?
Not in this world.
Well, it's a bad habit anyway. So this is all part of your sad magic act?
Kind of. It's more like a parlor trick.
Is that because we're in a parlor?
For now.
Wanna pound some more?
I wouldn't be opposed, but only if I can change the music.
there?
Yeah, hello.
How you been, kid?
Well, honestly, Jerry, I feel like shit. My number came up at the Squire last night, and I had a big, burly, 300-pound Mexican who drank me under the table for 8 rounds.
That's one of Amos Tanzio's boys, right?
Yeah, yeah. The Jalatino honey.
But you still won, right?
Is that a challenge?
You know what, Richie? I've always liked you. I bring in maybe 10 new recruits a year. Half of them are too stupid and get killed off. The other half turn out to be a bunch of backstabbing little bitches. But you, you got what the old school is called, moxie. Tell you what, you'd swing by the cave in a few hours. I gotta wait for you to double your earnings.
I am interested in such transactions, Sensei.
I'm in Colorado right now, looking at some very lonely mountains, thinking, boy, I wish my good friend Richie was here right now to try out some of this new grass that's been growing.
Don't tell me. You got me an all-expense-paid trip to sunny, balmy Colorado.
Not quite, but I am sending you a souvenir. How far are you from the train station?
Not far.
Good. My daughter Belinda's on her way into town. She's bringing 5 pounds of Jack Harris Sativa with her.
You need me to move?
That's the thing. I need you to not move. This is just a taste and sniff part. I know from this old cop buddy of mine, Danny, that the governor's gonna be cracking down all over town.
So you're trying to get out before all the chickens are shooed out of the coop?
Hey, Belinda will arrive around 2:30. You meet up with her at the train station and take all the bags. You'll leave together like two peas in a pod. She'll get in one cab that'll take her straight to the airport back to Rocky Mountain High, and you'll...
And I take a separate cab to 110th Street where I drop off the bag at Holy Toledo's Palace.
You got it, kid. Let it sit for a month, and after they've had a taste, you watch the money roll in.
All right, Jerry.
Like I said, though, go back to the cave when you're done, and my wife will give you some Scooby Snacks with the ride home.
Well, then I better get going, Jerry.
Of course. What am I doing slowing you down? Get out of here.
Aye, Jerry.
You know what, Richie? You may be a maniac, but at least you're on the right side.
I know.
How'd I get so lucky to get a partner like you?
Are you even listening to me? Hey! Hey!
Yeah, you don't have to shout at him. He'll snap out of it eventually.
You worked with these folks before?
My sister was a genie.
Really? That's crazy.
Why is it crazy?
It's coincidental to me that I'm hanging with a genie and you're having a genie sister.
Had.
Huh?
Had a genie sister. Gang of street kids. Well, you know, they made the gray pavement grayer.
I don't know what that means.
Killed her? Gray blood? Gray pavement?
Sorry. From the East Coast, and there aren't many Methuselans out there. Or at least exposed?
Without makeup? Correct.
Gonna ask me what I'm doing all the way out here, huh?
Listen, you're kind of shit-faced right now, and I have places to be, so could you just stop?
I'm a part of the genie police.
Yeah, right. You don't even know what to do when they zone out.
Well, I'm starting Monday.
Sure you do.
What do you do?
Please?
No, I'm interested. I don't know anyone here yet, and I could use a friend.
We're not friends.
Not yet.
calling to me. You can leave your buddy here overnight. Just remember to pick him up in the morning.
Who says I'm leaving? It's only Friday.
No. Now it's Saturday.
You want to go to dinner on Saturday?
Aren't you already having a drink with me?
No, I mean, dinner tonight. Like, the second tonight. Yeah, not the tonight we're already in.
You gonna be a jackass the whole time like you are now?
No. I'll be acting like a jackass to you when I'm sober. I'm kidding. Yeah. I'll be fine. I was just, you know, letting loose with a new partner. So, now that he's recharging or whatever, I'm talking to you. I was just wondering, would you like to continue talking over some hot plates tomorrow?
Let me think about it. Give me your phone.
So it's a date. Lola, I'm Craig.
No, it's a phone number. If you play your cards right and are nicer tomorrow, then maybe.
So I can sleep manic here? You really be like this for the rest of the night?
Maybe longer. Who knows?
You should probably help your friend.
Never told me.
Never told you what?
Where you work.
I'm a real estate agent. I was doing some pencil pushing for some model homes near here. I actually live more near Pickford.
So you lied to me.
Lied about what?
You said you had something going on later tonight.
Maybe I was thinking forward. I didn't think I had any engagements, but as it turns out, I did. Taking your drunk ass home.
You sound like those gray people.
This your place?
Yeah, this is me. Hey, thanks for letting my weird evening end on a normal note.
For sure.
See you tomorrow?
You mean tonight? Maybe. move out there?
Scotland?
Yeah, rolling hills or plains or whatever.
Probably not. I mean, I live here and I love the city life. I just don't think there'd be much for me to do out in the country.
But it'd be so much more pretty and you get to work with your hands and own land.
I mean, the 900 square feet I got in my apartment is pretty nice.
The city is just so dirty. So much crime.
True, but if there was no crime, then I'd be out of a job. I mean, I've lived in the small town long enough to know that the city life is way more exciting.
Way, way more exciting, hey boss?
Get out your gun.
They aren't issued until Monday.
Alright kids, let's empty out those wallets. You gotta pay up this troll if you wanna cross this bridge. But first, can I borrow your phones? I need to make a collect call. Great job. I'm proud of you two. Now reach into your pocket and reach into her purse. Same time. When those two hands come out, I better see all the money you two got in the both of them. You ready? Need to warm your hands up a little? Cause if you come up empty-handed and even just one hand, she dies first. Okay? Alrighty then. On the count of six. Six. Five. Four. Three, two, and one.
Little girl, put the gun down now.
I'm killing you, creepy shit. I'll blow both of them away. What, did both of you officers forget your guns at home?
Oh, sorry. Wrong pocket. Time to put this one away.
No!
What the hell are you doing? Do you know what it's like to die? It's painless. Well, if you have a body like me, you die. Oh well. Game over. Restart. Let's try it again with a little bit more flavor. But what would happen if you killed them?
They would die.
Manix, stop this, man. They would die? You mean like die?
Yes.
But I thought murder was wrong.
It is.
It is?
It is wrong.
It is? You made it look like so much. Don't mess around like this.
He's performing.
No, look. Now don't close your eyes, or you'll miss the trick.
No!
Now open wide.
Please?
And say ah!
No!
I guess you don't get to see the trick until next time. Haul it in. Where are you going?
One never knows these days.
I could see why they called him Manic Manix, but if there was one thing he showed me that night, it's that this world needs a little bit of magic. Maybe if we all lost our humanity, we could finally see it. Until then, we have these gray people who look past our vanity. Our army of magicians. Sideshow saviors.
hour.
Okay. We'll be right back.